Hello, dear students. I'm Dr. Mazhar Ali, and I welcome you to course Introduction to Artificial Intelligence. This is the first lecture of the course. So in this lecture, I shall present the introduction of artificial intelligence and its related domains. The artificial intelligence, commonly pronounced as AI, is a research and application discipline that includes the areas of robotics, perception systems, expert systems, natural language processing, fuzzy logic, neural networks, and genetic algorithms. Another area of artificial intelligence is basically artificial life, that is the study of computer instructions that act like living organisms. So artificial intelligence is basically an approach to make a computer, a robot, or a product to think about how smart human think. So AI is a study of how the human brain thinks, learn, decide, and work when it tries to solve problems. And finally, this study outputs intelligent software systems. Therefore, AI or artificial intelligence aims to improve computer functions which are related to human knowledge, for example, reasoning, learning, and problem solving. Or we may say that artificial intelligence is a group of related technologies that attempt to develop machines to emulate human-like qualities, such as learning, reasoning, and communicating, seeing, and hearing. Artificial intelligence is derived from intelligence. Now, artificial intelligence means a man-made intelligence. Since the intelligence is a natural product that is adopted by humans on basis of knowledge, experience, and so on. And when it is converted or it is developed in the machines, then it is called the artificial intelligence. So if we talk about artificial intelligence, or the intelligence, then the intelligence has been defined in many ways, like the capacity for logic, understanding, self-awareness, learning, emotional knowledge, reasoning, planning, creativity, critical thinking, and problem solving. So this problem, I mean, the intelligence can be considered as a common real life problem which we deal with many times in our lives. For example, if we look at this problem, because when we use our intelligence when we suffer from problems, therefore, this is a problem, like a mouse is here and this mouse tried to find out this cheese. So in this means finding a path. Finding a path is basically part of intelligence. To find a path, maybe to that may be a university path. For example, you want to reach your university and you are going first time to your university, you may find the path. Or to find a friend's house if you are going first time to your friend's house, or to find a path of market, or in this case, to please, in this problem, if you look here mouse wants to find the path of cheese, that where cheese is it, this mouse want to reach the cheese. So this problem is an example of intelligence. So mouse basically tries various paths as shown in this graph. If you see, there are different paths which are tried by mouse. And in other words, the mouse can find more than one solutions to this problem. Means a mouse has find several paths to reach the cheese. Therefore, mouse was intelligent enough to find a solution to the problem at hand. Hence, the ability of problem solving demonstrates intelligence. So intelligence means the knowledge, your reasoning, your thinking to solve them. When you use these things to solve the problem, so we use our intelligence in number finding, for example, 1, 3, 5, or 1, 5, 9, 10, and 16. And what will be the another number? Definitely, we will use our intelligence, or in a calculation, or in other problems, we use our intelligence. Or sometimes class finding according to timetable. For example, there is a main timetable of university. So how will you find your class in that timetable? So for this solution of this problem, you will use your intelligence. Therefore, intelligence can be described as the ability to perceive or infer information and to retain it as a knowledge to be applied towards adaptive behaviors within an environment or context. Another way to define intelligence, for example, nowadays the artificial intelligence used in different machines. So intelligence in machines is called artificial intelligence, which is commonly implemented in computer systems using programs and sometimes specialized hardware or robots. So as I told you already, artificial intelligence is an intelligence that is made by the humans, and that is made by humans to, also humans made the machine, especially the computer machine, intelligent to solve such type of the problems. So if we talk about the intelligent machines, then what machine can do? So a machine searches through a mesh and finds a path. For example, if you are working on different types of the network, you look how machine finds the another machine. For example, you are using social media or in any map, and you are from your country or your area, and you want to search the spot or the agent or the object or the person that lives in another country. So how will you find that person or reach that person? How definitely you will reach that person through machine which you are using, and your machine will find the machine that that person is using. So machine definitely search that machine through a mesh. Mesh is a type of the networking topology, and that machine find that machine through a complex network. Therefore, a machine can be intelligent, but nowadays machine is intelligent because machine intelligence is what's created when machines are programmed with some aspects of human intelligence, including learning, problem solving, and prioritization. So with these abilities, a machine can take the complex set of problems. It will do so using all aspects of human intelligence. As I told you, in this problem, even machine solves the problems like the next number in the sequence, as I told you previous. For example, you 1, 3, and 7, and 12 means and different numbers are added to the number. So machine can solve such type of the problems. Machine develops plans automatically, and machines diagnoses and diagnoses different diseases and prescribes the medicine accordingly. Machine answers your ambiguous questions, and machine recognizes fingerprints. Machine understands what are you thinking, what you want to say to the machine. Alexa is a very good example, and other intelligent machines or softwares are here that solve your psychological and other problems. The machine perceives as well what you want to say. Machine can perceive easily, and machine does many more such things which are not mentioned here. Even machine behaves as a human do. You see, look at the robots and other system machines which are adopted, which are fixed at different places. Even machine perform a role as a security guard. So robot may be a very good security guard. So we call such a machine intelligent, intelligent machine. So is this real natural, is this real or natural intelligence? means natural intelligence is adopted by human. Since the machine is developed with the intelligence by the humans, so a machine may not be called a real intelligent machine, but it is an artificial intelligent machine. So artificial intelligence artificial intelligence is basically refers to the simulation of human intelligence in machines that are programmed to think like humans and mimic their actions, that what human want to do or what human thinks machine performs accordingly. The term means artificial intelligence term may also be applied to any machine that exhibits traits associated with the human mind, such as learning and problem solving. So basically, if we talk about the artificial intelligence, it is a branch of the computer science, which is the science of making machines do things that would require intelligence if done by man. So it's said this definition is presented by Minsky. And Hoglander defined the artificial as a branch of computer science as well, which is the exciting new effort to make computers think. And Winston said that artificial intelligence is the study of computation that make it possible to perceive, reason, and act. Since the Rich and Knight said about artificial intelligence, that artificial intelligence is a study of how to do things which at the moment people do better. So, and MacArthur, the founder of the artificial intelligence, so this term artificial intelligence was termed by John MacArthur in 1956 at MIT. So it means a Dartmouth conference. There was a conference. In conference, artificial intelligence term was used by the MacArthur, since the concept was presented in 1950s by Alan Turing in a research paper, that there should be a computer intelligent machine. Intelligent, the concept of intelligent machine was presented by Alan Turing. And this term artificial intelligence was coined by John MacArthur in 1956. So if we talk about the birth of artificial intelligence, AI, Alan Turing, as I told you, raised the question of the possible intelligence of machine for the first time in his famous research article in 1950. The article title was Computing Machinery and Intelligence. So it was described in that paper, it was described a game of imitation. So where a human should be able to distinguish in a teletype dialogue whether he is talking to a man or a machine. So however controversial this article may be, this Turing test does not appear to qualify for many experts, but Word accept this test, and Alan Turing is the person who given the concept of intelligent machine. However, in the world, there are some people who are in opposition due to some reasons, but the majority of people and researchers, philosophers accepted the research paper, and definitely John MacArthur given this term on basis of that term, that concept which was presented by the Alan Turing in 1950. So it is a great job which is done by the Alan Turing in 1950s. Means a landmark. This paper may be called as a landmark research paper, which is written by the Alan Turing. And in this paper, Turing test was presented. But in 1956, at the Dartmouth conference, artificial intelligence term was presented by the John MacArthur. Therefore, so the term AI could be attributed to John MacArthur of MIT. Today, the main areas of artificial intelligence are reasoning, communicating, seeing, and eating, so on. So the other main areas, if we define the domains of artificial intelligence, these are the robotics, perception systems, knowledge representation or knowledge base, expert systems, natural language processing, commonly called the NLP, fuzzy logic, machine learning, neural networks, genetic algorithms, and computer vision. These are main domain of artificial intelligence, or these are the fields in which artificial intelligence methods are used. So robotic is a field that attempts to develop machine that can perform work normally done by people. The machines themselves, of course, are called robots. So a robot is an automatic device that performs functions ordinarily ascribed to human beings, or that operates with what appears to be almost human intelligence. The example of a robot is the Dente 2 is a common example of the robot machine. Therefore, the robot or the machine is a machine, or robots are machines. So those machines which are working automatically with the proper artificial intelligence systems, and individually they are basically a robot, and a robotics is a category in which different robots are worked. Therefore, a robot is an automatic device that performs functions ordinarily ascribed to human beings. So there are nowadays in the developed countries, robots are used in different factories, organizations for different purposes, because the robots work like a human. Even several people are using robots for their security purposes, because a robot is a more intelligent, and there are several cameras are inserted in robots from different all sides, which look around the person that who is the enemy or any terrorist or so on. So there is a very common use nowadays of the robots in the different countries and organizations and industries, factories, and so on. So it is a very significant part of the artificial intelligence. Another part of artificial intelligence is a perception system. Perception systems are sensing devices that emulate the human capabilities of sight, hearing, touch, and smell. Clearly, perception systems are related to robotics, since robots need to have at least some sensing capabilities. Examples of perception systems are vision systems used for pattern recognition. Vision systems are the pattern recognition in a factory assembly lines. So to discriminate among parts of shapes, a robot measures the varying intensities of light of the parts. Each intensity has a numbered value that is compared to a similar palette of intensities stored in the system's memory. So if the intensity is not recognized, the part is rejected. An example of this kind of perception is the bin vision systems used by General Electric to pick up specific parts. So these are very important functions of the perceptions, and definitely perception systems are used by the intelligent machine, that may be robot or computer machine or any other machine. Another important and very growing part of the artificial intelligence system is the expert system. So expert system is an interactive computer program that helps users solve problems that would otherwise require the assistance of a human expert. Even the you may even say that it is a collection of rules of this type are sometimes known as a production system. So this architecture was even taken seriously as a model of human cognition. Two of its main champions in this regard were Alan Norrell and Herbert Simon. They performed a very important role in the development of expert systems. The expert system, for example, the Meissen, helps diagnose infectious diseases. Meissen is an expert system that diagnoses the diseases and prescribes the medicine accordingly. It is a very famous type of the expert system. But nowadays, different business organizations are using expert systems to solve their business problems. Even the banks are using the expert systems for the identification of their clients. And banks are using expert systems in loans and other activities. So even the security organizations are also using the expert system. So there is a very wide use of the expert systems nowadays. So an expert system consists of three components. Means if we talk about the structure of the expert system, it is consists of three components, that is the knowledge base, inference engines, and user interface. And when we talk about knowledge base, so there are the rules, set of rules, the rule-based system. So knowledge base is an expert system's database of knowledge about a particular subject. This includes relevant facts, information, beliefs, assumptions, and procedures for solving problems. The basic unit of knowledge is expressed as an if-then-else rule. Means if this, then action. So this condition is used in the knowledge base. If this happens, then this rule may be applied. Since the inference engine is the software that controls the search of the expert system's knowledge base and produce some conclusions on based on facts, means there should be the facts. So it takes the problem posed by the user of the system and fits it into the rules in the knowledge base. It then drives a conclusion from the facts and rules contained in the knowledge base. And the reasoning may be by a forward chain or a backward chain. So in the forward chain of a reasoning, the inference engine begins with the statement of the problem from the user. And it then proceeds to apply any rule that fits the problem. So in the backward chain of reasoning, the system works backward from a question to produce an answer. And what happens in the user interface, that is also part of the expert system. So the user interface is the display screen that the user deals with. So it gives the user the ability to ask questions and get answers, and it also explains the reasoning behind the answer. So therefore, expert system is a very important part of artificial intelligence that works automatically on the basis of knowledge base and facts and inference engine. Another type of the part of the artificial intelligence is the natural language processing. Natural language processing is commonly pronounced as the NLP. So NLPs are human languages such as English and other languages. These are the human languages. These languages are ordinarily, as I told you, human languages. Human languages means it is taught by the humans in this world. So NLP is a study of ways for computers to recognize and understand human language, whether in a spoken or a written form. Today, computer machine includes handheld computer translate, even the handheld computer, laptops, other type of the computers or robots, these all are translated number of English sentences to various language of word, even the translate the various languages to English and other languages of the word. So NLP is a very important part of the artificial intelligence, especially in this digital age, because after the globalization and growth of the internet, word is converted into global village, and all languages, or languages means the human languages, are made significant. All languages are considered important. Therefore, the NLP domain is developed, and several people are working in this domain to solve the linguistic problems of different languages and make them the universal languages. Fuzzy logic is a method of dealing with imprecise data and uncertainty with problems that have many answers rather than one. It is a new concept being used in the development of natural languages. And the traditional, if we look at the traditional logic behind computers, that was based on either yes or no, means a Boolean. Traditional logic was the Boolean, but still we are using the traditional logic in different programming and different solutions for in different solutions for problems, or true or false and so on. So since the fuzzy logic is a method of dealing with the imprecise data and uncertainty with the problems that have many answers rather than the one. So definition, the fuzzy logic has been used in numerous applications such as facial pattern when you are using the machine learning or deep learning. You are developing models, and machine learning and deep learning, you solve these problems which I mentioned here. Means in those models, you may use the fuzzy logic for the purpose of solving the purpose of problem solutions of the facial pattern recognition. Even the air conditioners are using the fuzzy logic. You see nowadays digital conditions or electronic air conditions are using the fuzzy logic. They solve your they save your power consumption and other things. Washing machines are working on base of the fuzzy logic. Vacuum cleaners are working on basis of the fuzzy logic. Transmission system, the control of subway systems, and knowledge-based systems for multiple objective optimization of power system, etc., are working on based on fuzzy logic. So it is a very much important and significant logic which is a part of the artificial intelligence. Now, even if we take a very common example of fuzzy logic, if you look at elevators in different shopping malls and in different organizations, they are using the fuzzy logic. You look at that, how long will most people wait in an elevator before getting in the chance? So that is also using the fuzzy logic to solve their to run the elevators properly. Another part of the artificial intelligence is the machine learning and the deep learning. So deep learning is using neural networks. There are neurons in our mind. So on the basis of working of neurons, artificial neural network is developed to solve the real world problems. So artificial neural networks are called commonly pronounced as ANN. Mathematical or computational, it is a mathematical or computational model that tries to simulate the structure or functional aspects of biological neural networks. The human using the biological neural networks, however, in computer system, artificial biological neural network is developed. If you look here, these are the neurons which are networked with each other. So this is the input. We input different things from the input source, and these are the hidden layers. Now hidden layer is uncountable. There may be 2, 4, 100 and so on. So it depends on your model, that how your model is a complex, and then these hidden layer gives you the output, what we input, that is processed through the hidden layers, and then the output may be received. So such network can be used to run complex functions, for example, and we will discuss these all things in the coming lecture in detail. Here I just tell you briefly their names and very simple functions. So we may call neural networks use physical electronic devices or software to develop some neurological structure of the human brain, that is definitely artificial neurological structure of the human brain. The same network, same artificial neurological structure is developed in the computer system to solve the real world problems. So, and another type of the artificial intelligence systems are the probabilistic, means artificial intelligence solve the probability and statistical problems. So rigorous applications of probability theory and statistics in AI generally gained in popularity in 1990 and are now the dominant of the time. And for example, it is a very good in the machine learning. Machine learning is working on basis of probability and some statistical approaches, pattern recognition and machine perception, for example, computer vision, speech recognition, robotics, natural language processing are working on basis of this. So this is also a significant part of the artificial intelligence. Another very important part of the artificial intelligence is the genetic algorithm. A genetic algorithm is a search heuristic that is inspired by the Charles Darwin's theory of natural evolution. So a genetic algorithm is a program that uses Darwin principles of random mutation to improve itself. The algorithms are lines of computer code that act like living organisms. And different sections of code haphazardly come together producing programs. Like Darwin's rules of evolution, many chunks of code compete with each other to see which can best perform the desired solution. The aim of the program, so some chunks will even become extinct. So those that survive will combine with other survivors and will produce offspring programs. So a genetic algorithm, commonly called the GA, is a method for solving both constraint and unconstraint optimization problems based on a natural selection process that mimics biological evolution. And even you may say the genetic algorithm provide computers with the method of problem solving, which is based upon implementations of evolutionary process. So these are this also this algorithm will be discussed in coming lectures. So artificial intelligence nowadays day to day is improving and developing. There are several applications of artificial intelligence in various type of organizations, industries, but I tell you a very little number of applications. For example, there is a very good usage or application of artificial intelligence in hospitals or clinics. Means it can use a hospital can use the AI system to organize bed schedules, make a staff rotation, and provide medical information. AI has also an application in fields of cardiology, neurology, embryology, like the sonography, complex operations of internal organs, and etc. So it also has an application in image-guided surgery and image analysis and enhancement. Nowadays, majored big hospitals in the developed countries are using robots and other AI procedures to solve the medical problems. Even music. You see, nowadays, there's a very good application of artificial intelligence in the music. So scientists are trying to make the computer emulate the activities of the skillful musician. Means, for example, a singer, which are very much known and experts in their field, and now they are not available in this world, means they are died. You may develop an artificial intelligence system and which will sing in the sound and of those singers. Their style of singing, the voice will be same. And even you may make up artificial poetry of the very known and important poets which are died nowadays, but you may generate poems of in the style of those poets. And even the robotic is an important usage of the artificial intelligence. A robot is a mechanical or a virtual artificial agent, usually an electromechanical machine that is guided by a computer program or electron circuitry. So this is a significant application of artificial intelligence, which is used in different ways. I told you already in previous slides. A very good application of artificial intelligence is used for different games. And nowadays, if you look at different, if you look online gaming or offline gaming, you will find all the artificial intelligence in all games. So chess, Sudoku, and even several famous games are using the artificial intelligence algorithm. Bank is also using the artificial intelligence organized for the purpose of different operations and investment, stocks, loans, and so on. Even the ATMs are designed on the basis of artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence makes the system safe and important. So thank you very much for watching this lecture. This was simple and brief lecture on the introduction of artificial intelligence. We discussed the basic concept of artificial intelligence, that where it is used and what is the purpose of artificial intelligence, what it lies, how organizations are using the artificial intelligence. In coming lectures, we will discuss the fields or domains which we discussed in detail. Take care.